Hey, this is Foy Vance, and you're watching me on Tiscali.
Welcome, Foy, to Tiscali.
Thanks for having me.
Lovely to have you here. So you have grown up around the church. Your dad was a preacher.
Yeah, when I was younger, a lot younger, I grew up around the church.
Okay. That obviously made you the person who you are, and that obviously influenced you musically.
Yeah, you know, I think the first music that I was ever introduced to was just singing, congregational singing.
Did you go along and sing in choirs and things like
well,
that?
Well, my dad was the preacher of the church, so they would all come to the house. And this is in Oklahoma, you know, the deep west of America. So it was all the songs were all real sort of classic hymns, and you know, but also like you know a lot of influence from the cotton fields, if you like, you know, all that stuff.
I bet that singing there was just something else. I mean, you hear and see it on movies, don't you? And you just think, God, wow, what voices they have, and what amazing soulful voices they have. So it must have been brilliant for you.
Yeah, no, it was beautiful because I mean, it was weird in a sense because the church didn't have they didn't allow music. Which I think is very bizarre. I sort of can't get my head around that. No. But they didn't allow musical instruments, is what I mean. So it was just the voice. But you know, that suited me fine. So, you know, because anytime you went to church, it was just people singing. I found that very infectious. And I guess if you're, you know, singing those sorts of songs as well, you know, they were connecting with something spiritual. So
fantastic. So for people that don't know you, know your sound, what do you sound like now? Is it still very much quite soulful sound, or is it something completely different?
I guess it's soulful. I find it really difficult to define sounds, you know what I mean? I'm not trying to be elusive or, you know, trying to be cool or, you know, I can't define anybody, you know, tell me to define what the Chili Peppers are or what Prince is or what, you know, Damien Rice is, I couldn't tell you.
Okay, so defining your sound, who would you say you sound like, maybe, with that?
I'm not sure who I sound like. You're meant to listen to it and tell me that. I'm just meant to go for something unique. Am I not? I get, you know, I listen to everything. I'm influenced by everything, you know, from Elvis Costello and Anthony and the Johnsons and Joni Mitchell, Bob Dylan, Van Morrison. You know, the list goes on.
Yeah, absolutely.
Sex Pistols, Exploited, Damned, The Clash.
Okay, I love them all. Big wide range of people.
Absolutely, you know what I mean? There's two types of music, there's good and there's bad, and you know, I like a bit of both.
Yeah. So you've had an album recently out last year. How's that going?
It's going good, I guess. You know, it's sort of, I always wanted it to be a slow burn. You know, I set up my own label called Word of Mouth Records.
Right, okay. And didn't you produce, mix, everything, do everything for this album?
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, I had a hand in a wee bit of everything, you know, but there were other people to bake the cake with me. You know, I know my limitations, so I got really good people in to mix it with me. You know, so this guy called Chad Blake, I really love his work. He's mixed like Pearl Jam and Tom Waits.
Right,
fantastic. You know, like all, you know.
Yeah.
Everyone that I'm into, he's worked on their albums, so yeah, I got him, and it's going good. But I set up the label Word of Mouth just because the whole idea was that I wanted it to spread by word of mouth, you know, because I think that's the one thing you can't argue with, you know. Everything that I really like and I'm really influenced by, I found out from a friend, really. I didn't find out from listening to radio or watching TV or, you know, generally speaking.
So how do you get you around then? Even though you say word of mouth is obviously your label and what you hope to have to spread you, do you use things like MySpace and Facebook and all that kind of stuff to get people to know about you?
Well, I do. When you say use MySpace, I have a MySpace, you know, but I generally just add friends on it and let them know when gigs are coming. I'm not very sort of aggressive with that. What I am aggressive about, if you like, is the gigging. You know, I like to gig a lot. I think live is where it's. I think it's the one thing that can't be reproduced. You know, everything else can be put on YouTube or you know, ripped onto MP3, which is cool. You know, I have no issue with that whatsoever. But the live thing is, you know what I mean. It is what it is, and so that's my thing, I guess.
And so, what can we expect from your set tonight?
The unexpected.
The unexpected.
I don't know. Well, just, you know, be a bit of everything. Everything, that's what you expect. I'll throw everything at it, whether you like it or not.
That's
another thing.
We'll be there for like 3 hours and
everything. Yeah, there you go.
Well, thank you very much for talking to us, Foy.
My pleasure.
Lovely to have you here.
Thanks for having me.
And best of luck with everything.
Thanks, Lucy.
Thank you.